morning, members of press. My name is Brian Ron, and here is my spouse, Deborah Muriuki. We've learned with shock that it was yesterday. We learned with shock that her name is appearing on the BBI proponents list, and it tells us that her signature was forged. Her details were also put into that list without her consent, without her knowledge. It's very unfortunate that we had to learn about this while I was hospitalized. So we came here today very early in the morning to the Deputy County Commissioner's office to find answers as to why her name is appearing on the BBI proponent list, file one from the IEBC website. And two, we also want to find out who exactly collected that signature and who signed on her behalf, because that is fraud and that is criminal. It is interesting that we come from a very small community called Tinet. And in Tinet Primary School polling station, her name is the only one that is appearing. She did not sign, she did not appear, she was not there. Now what we are asking ourselves is, who collected that signature? Who signed on her behalf? What happened? Which process did they use, or criteria did they use to find her name? How did they acquire her details, her name? Probably her name would be in the public domain, but how did they acquire her ID number to be used in the BBI proponent list? Now, the most interesting part is, she transferred her vote in 2016 to Tinet Primary from Meru. In 2017, she was an IEBC clerk in the same polling station. Today, we are finding her name in the BBI list. What does it tell you? That there is somebody who's using the system in IEBC to collect the data of voters and use it for their own benefit. Thirdly, she's having a problem now to assimilate to the society. This is a small community where people see you as part of that community. In this community, we are not the majority, we are few. It is a polling station with less than 500 votes. We know each and every person in every household. It is a small community. How is she supposed to assimilate in a community where they are saying they do not support BBI? How is it coming out that people are learning that she signed the BBI document, yet she didn't sign? How does it reflect in the community? So we're already having a problem. This is fraud. This is identity theft. This is an infringement into the privacy of people. This is an attack on family units. We were peaceful. We didn't want to be involved in the BBI politics. But again, we are finding ourselves on the front lines of one of our family member data being used without her consent. It is very wrong. They normally say the law is as good as its process, or the process of making that law. Every result, what is a result? It is the product of a process. The process is already dented. The people who are in that list, like my wife here, is not aware that her name is appearing. So if out of all the signatures they've collected, this is the case, what does it tell you about the process of that constitution making? This country has been left to the dogs. This country is headed in the wrong direction. It's supposed to defend the rights of its people. It's supposed to defend the fundamental rights of each and every citizen. It's supposed to protect families from psychological torture, from cyberbullying, from their information being used without their consent. Where are we headed? So today, we are seeking that information from the Deputy County Commissioner's office through the DC or the DO. We also have the Assistant County Commissioner who's coming. We have gone to the DCI. We are going to report. We are going to the last point. We are not leaving any stone unturned until we find out who exactly is this person that picked her details to be used in this scam. So we did not have a problem with the whole of this process. Whatever they were doing, we did not want to be engaged. But see how the process is going. If down here, as a voter, we are finding ourselves in this situation, what about the rest of the countrymen in this nation? Where are we headed as a country? Where are we headed as a nation? And I'll give her time to tell you exactly how she feels, what she feels. So we are very disappointed, and now this puts us on the front line of the whole of this process. We will not spare any resource, we will not spare any information in the pursuit of justice of what has been done to us. This is wrong, this is defamation, it is just wrong. The process is not suitable. The process, the law can only be as good as the process of making it. It does not belong to people. And lastly, let me say this, power can only be derived from the people. It's a derivative of the people. Constitutional law is a derivative of the will of the people. And if the will of the people is not reflected, then that process is dented. And therefore, we are going to make a dented constitution amendment in the end of the process. So the whole of this thing is not running out well. It is not working well with us. We already have a problem with it from a personal view, from a family view. Now it is on the national level. If we are able to find her details online, people are sharing that who is this person in this polling station that has signed BBI. Imagine how we would sleep at night. Imagine how we would wake up. Imagine how we would be welcomed into our society, into the small community that we come from. It is very wrong. We are highly and so much aggravated, and we will not tire to find out what exactly happened.
Okay, my name is Deborah Gatiri Murillo. I'm the one, my information is circulating on social media that I support the BBI. I didn't sign, I had no idea about BBI. And this, I'll call it a scam or an intimidation to our national government. Finding my information on IBC website that I signed the BBI, and they verified the signatures, but I didn't sign on the lowest level where the forms were being signed. I had no idea who was signing, who had the forms that were being signed. I had no idea who was on charge of this BBI story. And I would like to know how they got my information. That is what I want to find out. How did they get my signature? How did they verify my signature that I signed the BBI form? And I don't support the BBI. Thank you.